So, the time has come. Once, you asked me how it all started. Sit down, my young apprentice, and I will try to satisfy your curiosity. Let's begin by the day I was expelled from the ranks of the necromancers. I had been a friend and supporter of Belketh since the first days of the spider cult. Yet our ultimate goals couldn't be reconciled. We had found a way to free ourselves from Usher's cycle of life and death, and to elevate ourselves beyond the limitations of our mortal shells. And yet, Belketh thought our purpose was to serve Usher, something I couldn't accept. I chose to play along, all the while starting to advocate another secret current of thought within the cult. The arrival of the creature known as the Mother Namtaru ruined my plans.
Necromancer Sandro, you are accused of fomenting treason against the great Archon Belketh and the Spider Cult. The Mother Namtaru has spoken. Shall I repeat her words?
By all means, Merrick, please entertain these old bones.
Soul bound to bone, he would not bow. Seeing beyond Asha's veil, and yet stranger to her, a lord of the nether, a prophet of the void, visionary, destroyer, mad with sanity, scheming in the shadows against the spider.
And what's that supposed to mean? That doesn't even rhyme. Are the cryptic prophecies of a demented spirit enough to condemn me?
Enough! You should be destroyed for your blasphemy. Your soul bound to a ghoul and your bones scattered to the wind. You're fortunate that the great Archon has chosen to be merciful. Lord Belketh remembers you were one of his first followers. This is why he decided you would be merely exiled from our congregation.
They left me with my life, so to speak, but stripped me of all my possessions before escorting me out of Al-Betil, warning me never to set foot in the Seven Cities again. It could have been worse. After all, even my most powerful artifacts can be replaced. My greatest loss was my staff of power. It took me years to find a suitable replacement. The Duke of Bull Ovidio had a soft spot for old artifacts, especially those forbidden by the Church of the Light. He had recently obtained an ancient rod known as the Staff of the Netherworld. This was just what I needed.
Thank you. goes there? Show yourself. Ah, you're one of those.
How positively refreshing. Usually denizens of the Holy Empire greet me with pitchforks and torches. We meet at last, Countess de la Segadora.
So you're Sandro. I should have guessed someone using a raven as a messenger would have morbid tastes. Let's get down to business, shall we? You make my horse uncomfortable.
That which takes you far is never comfortable. I've heard that since the accidental death of his father, you've had some troubles with the young Duke of Video. It seems he's mostly been busy throwing luxurious parties and replacing nobles he doesn't like with his own minions.
You certainly did your research. Ovidio says I'm a suspect in his father's death. He used it as an excuse to banish me from the court, strip me of my title and my land.
Then perhaps we can do something for each other. I am here to acquire an artifact from the Duke's private collection.
I know about that collection, but don't believe they'll let you even approach the Summer Palace.
What I believe is that you know of another way to enter the castle. A service entrance, so to speak. Now, in the hypothetical situation where you would be willing to share this information with me, what would be your price?
Ovidio gave La Segadora to his favorite. I want you to scare this damn sycophant off. I cannot regain my title, but I can make sure every citizen of the city sees him for the coward he is. Just do not kill him.
I like you already. My lady, you have yourself a deal.
Oh.
Looks like Ovidio did not lose any time sending his dogs after the stolen hourglass. No matter. This artifact is too precious to leave it in the hands of someone who does not understand its true power.
Thank you. Thank you.
Many decades have passed since my last visit, but there's a place I haven't forgotten. There's a certain monastery in this area which I remember all too well. Once I swore I would one day show how twisted and corrupted it really is. I now know just the perfect way to keep that promise. Who said conversion worked in only one direction?
the meaning of this, necromancer? Why would you attack us? Oh, wait. Lucretia's behind this, isn't she? Damn you, sister.
You are more cunning than she gives you credit for.
She's jealous because I play the political game better than she does. She never understood that the game required finesse. Now I have allies in high places. I have power. So I suggest you back off while you can, foul creature.
She now has the only ally she needs. As for power, let me show you what that word truly entails.
Great Elrath! Shield me from this aberration with your holy light!
Is that all you can do, worthless dog? Beg your dragon god for salvation? I am the shadow of death, come to harvest your soul.
Is the deed done?
Your brother learnt a valuable lesson today about finesse.
So you found that out?
Oh, I already knew. I did my research, as you said yourself. Now, I think you have something to tell me.
There's a tunnel in the castle's vaults leading to a spirit gate. It was built to allow the Duke and his family to escape the palace in case of siege, but it can also be used the other way round, to get in. To reactivate it, you'll need to locate two dragon eyes. Those are the keys to reopen the portal. I'll come with you and help you find them.
You might like to reconsider your offer, my lady. If you tread on this path and become my accomplice, you will be branded as an outlaw in the Holy Empire.
I'm sick of this empire and its so-called holiness. I'd like to see what this world has to offer beyond the pointless game of politics and hypocrisy.
Thank you.
They thought they could break me, force me to accept the foolish notion of absolute truth. They said there were no other worlds beyond our own, but I walked them in my dreams. They are real. One day all will see. How many years have passed since the last time I came here? 100 years? More? There's a tomb near La Segadora that has been waiting for my visit. It's long overdue.
Ah, here you are. What has drawn you to our family crypt?
Just an old ghost, nothing really. I'm finished here. Let's move on.
Only my great-grandmother is buried here. Her name was Alma. Like your raven.
Perfect. The gate is now open. It should allow me to sneak into a video's summer palace to find the staff I've been looking for.
I won't let you get your rotten hands on the prize of my collection, Skullface. My dear Giovanni warned me of your presence in my duchy. Do you really think you could break into my castle unnoticed? And you, Lucretia, colluding with a heretic? This is despicable, even for you.
Heretic? That's very much the pot calling the kettle black. Since you became the Duke, your reign has been marked by scandal and decadence.
At least it wasn't marked by boredom and sermons. I'm merely enjoying everything life has to offer. You, on the other hand, you seduced my father, made him reject my mother, and I'm sure you had a hand in his assassination as well. So, who's the black kettle again?
I never gave your father anything he wasn't willing to take. As for his death, you have no proof to support your lie.
This skull face is tired of your bickering. I've come for the staff of the Netherworld, and I'm leaving with it. Stand aside, or return to Usher.
You dare threaten a Duke of the Empire? I will destroy you, you filthy sack of bones!
My name is Sandro, and I take great pleasure in ridding the world of stupid, boastful creatures like yourself.
Killed him? Do you have any idea of the things I had to do to gain his favor? He's of no use to me dead! You'll pay for this, sister. I'll make sure everyone in the Empire knows the part you played in this.
Your life is now at a crossroads, Lucretia. You are an outcast and a fugitive in the Empire. You could flee to the free cities and try to start a new life there, in Stonehelm or in Hammerfall.
I could never stand to be a nobody in some faraway hole, as I'm sure you already know.
Which brings us to the other choice. I could teach you the art. Show you what lies beyond the veil of this reality. Is that what you want?
It is, Master.
Then come, my disciple. We have a long road ahead of us. And this is how it all started. The very first step. My very first follower. Ah, but I can see you want to know why I needed the staff of the Netherworld. Do not worry, my young apprentice. I will tell you about it.